A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28th July, Sunday. On the front page, you have 1,050 passengers rescued from stranded train near Mumbai. So National Disaster Response Force, Army and the Navy engaged in 10-hour rescue after flood waters inundated the tracks of this long distance train, and over 1,050 passengers were rescued. So this was Mumbai Kolhapur Mahalakshmi Express near Badlapur, where a heavy overnight rain resulted in tracks being inundated, covered by flood water. Then this is Finance Ministry Niti Aayog guidelines ignored in airport prioritization. So this is saying this is how the Finance Ministry recommendation not to award the same player more than two airports out of the total six to be privatized by the center was among some of the key suggestions brushed aside by the government panel for public private partnership appraisal committee. So this is regarding handing over airports to private sector in public private partnership. So Adani Group has been awarded all the airports, five out of the six airports are with Adani Enterprises. So it and later even the last one, so it's emerged as the winning bidder for all the airports. The Finance Ministry had actually recommended that not more than two airports should be provided to the same player. So Union Cabinet has given in principle approval to privatize these six airports which are owned by Airport Authority of India. So this is how key recommendations have been ignored. Even the Finance Ministry's Department of Economic Affairs and Niti Aayog, those suggestions as such to improve criteria for selecting bidders, these were brushed aside. So even this is in the context of Subhash Chandra Garg, who was then Secretary of Economic Affairs. So he has taken voluntary resignation when he was shifted to some other, when it was announced that he would be shifted to some other ministry, he preferred to take voluntary retirement. Then this is GST on electric vehicles chargers cut to 5%. So GST Council has decided to reduce tax rate on electric vehicles, which will be brought down from 12% to 5%. So first it will be, and also for chargers, it was 18% GST, which will be brought down to 5%, which will be applicable from 1st August 2019. Then on page 2, you have government draws flak after NGT bans stone crushers in Mahendragarh. So Swaraj India has hit out at authorities and alleged nexus between officials and the owners. And the BJP government has been criticized because now the National Green Tribunal has given its order to immediately close all illegal pollution causing stone crushers in Mahendragiri in Haryana. So this is Mahendragarh district of Haryana. Then next is draw up action plan for revamping existing mechanism. So National Green Tribunal has asked Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Environment and Forests to ensure effective monitoring of environmental clearances. So when environmental clearances are given to projects, then there should be effective monitoring of this by the ministry is what the National Green Tribunal is asking for. It has asked the ministry to draw up an action plan for revamping the existing mechanisms. Then on page 7 you have Nagaland forms panel to frame REIN modalities. So REIN is Register of Indigenous Inhabitants of Nagaland. So this is a REIN exercise which has been initiated by Nagaland after Assam's NRC exercise has been going on now. So it has taken a cue from it and it is preparing its own register of indigenous inhabitants. So Nagaland presently has constituted a commission to frame the modalities for creating this register. So details will be finalized or, you know, formed by this commission. So they say REIN is important to ensure that indigenous inhabitant certificates are not given to ineligible persons. That is the purpose. Then on page 10 you have Pentagon nod for military sales to India, Pakistan. So US State Department has decided to approve a possible foreign military sale to India of the C-17 aircraft's follow-on support, which will cost around $670 million. And also it will provide the F-16s monitoring of F-16s in Pakistan. So this is, you can see this, you know, little where you can see it will be worth $125 million. So that would result in monitoring of the F-16 fighter jets of Pakistan. So USA provides, you can see, C-17 aircraft to India and fighter jets F-16 to Pakistan. So foreign military sales would take place. So it means Pakistan itself would be paying, India itself would be paying for these sales. On page 11, you have Houston calling with big diaspora event for PM. So this is regarding US visit, which Prime Minister Narendra Modi is to make to USA. So this US visit will be in September 2019. So we have India-US relations been rocky recently because of impasse in trade talks also, and recent statement of President Trump on Kashmir to become a mediator on Kashmir. Then this is three military logistics pacts on the anvil. So India is looking to conclude three military logistics support agreements by end of 2019, which will further enhance operational reach of the military in the region. So India has already signed such an agreement with few countries like USA. Now it is going to sign with Australia. Talks are going on with Australia, Japan and Russia. Then on international page, you have ditch backstop or face no deal exit. So this is what the new UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson has told European Union. So under former Prime Minister Theresa May, the British and EU had finalized a Brexit divorce deal, and this deal was not approved by the British Parliament. So eventually the Prime Minister had to step down, and another member from her own political party, the Conservative Party, Boris Johnson, has become the new Prime Minister. So he is a hard Brexiteer, you can see. He says that British PM, he as a British PM is urging Europe to renegotiate the withdrawal agreement. European Union has clearly stated it would not be renegotiating, but then what he wants is the backstop provision which is there in the withdrawal agreement should be, withdrawal agreement is the Brexit divorce date, so that should be removed. So what is this backstop? You should understand that UK as its constituents also has Northern Ireland as part of it. So this is United Kingdom, you can see, and this is Northern Ireland. So Ireland here is a separate country, but the northern part of this region is under UK control. It's part of UK. So it was also a colony of British, but when they gave independence, they kept this part with itself. So Northern Ireland is part of UK and Ireland is a separate country. So after Brexit, the only land border which UK will have, because it does not have land boundary. So UK's only land border with EU post Brexit would be this. So what is this backstop agreement? So means presently, since UK is part of European Union, there is free movement of goods and services, which is possible, goods and people flowing freely across the border without custom checks. But then if the Brexit happens, then UK will not be part of European Union, and here this will become a hard border. So the reintroduction of border controls between UK's Northern Ireland and EU's member island would take place then. And presently how the goods are flowing freely without custom checks, that would not be possible. So it was actually under 1998 peace accord also, the border has virtually become made invisible. But now the new British Prime Minister says that backstop provision should be ditched, should be eliminated from the Brexit deal. So this is a further detail given. So transition period, you can see. The plan which Theresa May had finalized with EU, so it had that during transition period there would be no checks, and then backstop would be brought in. Some checks would be there from Northern Ireland to Ireland. So that is the backstop, and then you can see. So this is what would happen in backstop, and no deal. This is present scenario, and this is some checks which is part of backstop, and if there is no deal, then this will become a hard border. And here this will be part of UK, so the internally they can have free movement, but this will become a hard border, heavy checks here. So that is a cause of concern. So this backstop means here it will be a soft border, here there will be some checks. Then below you have US Guatemala sign asylum deal. So this is a landmark asylum agreement which has been signed between USA and Guatemala. Guatemala is a Central American country. It lies next to Mexico, so it's having border with Mexico. And USA has finalized this asylum agreement under which now Guatemala would be considered as a safe third country. It means that US bound migrants who enter into Guatemala would be required to seek asylum there instead of going to USA. So Mr. Trump said that the deal will provide safety to legitimate asylum seekers and stop asylum fraud. This is it. On business page, you have Model Tenancy Act will rebuild trust between owners and tenants. So this is Model Tenancy Act 2019, which has been drafted by Union Minister of Housing and Urban Development. It is expected to benefit both owners and tenants. So releasing a lot of housing stock for rental purposes. So this is regarding how there's a huge trust deficit prevalent between homeowners and tenants. So this has created a huge demand supply gap. So now more landowners, after the Model Tenancy Act will be in place, they would be ready to rent out. Then on Sundays, you have this FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions, so on issues which are in news through the week. So here the first one is, why does India say no to Kashmir mediation? So what are the historical reasons why third party mediation is avoided by the government, and will the status quo on India's Kashmir policy remain? So these are the questions in the context of US President Donald Trump claiming that he was asked by Prime Minister Modi to become a mediator in Kashmir. Asked whether he wants to become a mediator in Kashmir. So UN early attempts at mediation by the UN were made after India took its complaint against Pakistan's forced occupation of parts of Kashmir, that is present-day Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, to UN Security Council in 1948. But at that time, UN set up United Nations Commission for India and Pakistan, which proposed mediating a resolution along a 3-point action plan. That is Pakistani demilitarization of the Kashmir region and Indian reduction in military presence and final resolution by an impartial UN-administered plebiscite to determine the wishes of Kashmiri people. But this deal never got off the ground and Pakistan never agreed to demilitarize. And India and the Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru made it clear that a plebiscite would never be accepted. So this became a failure. So that is that. So when UN mediation was also initiated, this is what has happened. So USA had supported Pakistan. So that is seen. Also, another attempt at mediation was by USA. So this was after the 1962 India-China war. So during this war, USA had provided us military hardware worth $60 million, and but India lost to China in the 1962 war. And for further help, American officials said that India would have to agree to mediated talks with Pakistan on Kashmir issue. So the mediated talks took place, but then eventually Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru made it clear that USA is not going to give up Kashmir Valley. Then another issue which is discussed here is regarding cleaner air, higher costs. So this is regarding Bharat Stage 6, the mass emission standards for various classes of motor vehicles, which has to be put into effect by April, which will come into effect by April 2020. So what will the move to bring these standards have on the motor vehicles, various classes of motor vehicles, is discussed here. And this is what is zero budget natural farming. So this chemical free agriculture, how it increases farmers' income and what are the pitfalls in it, are discussed in this article. So here you can see the person who is behind this, Subhash Palekar, who has promoted zero budget national farming and has been awarded Padma Shri also for this, is here. Then on Sundays, you have science and technology coverage. So here the first article is IIT Madras breath humidity sensors for wearable electronics. So this is what IIT Madras researchers have developed. So it detects ethanol, acetone, and oral breath of alcoholics, diabetics, respectively. Then this is regarding predicting pollution, and these are related to animals, bees, zebrafish, which is generally not asked by UPSC. Then on the last page you have World Health Organization recommends use of innovative HIV drug. So this is dolutegravir, which is safe for pregnant women too. So this new evidence of assessing benefits and risks has been used by World Health Organization in recommending the use of HIV drug dolutegravir, DTG. So this is preferred first line and second line treatment for all populations, including pregnant women and those of childbearing potential. And below you have vanishing wildlife. 22 species have gone extinct in India. So this is the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, which has listed habitat degradation as one of the main causes for 22 species going missing in India. These are 4 species of fauna, animals, and 18 species of flora, that is plants. So they have gone extinct in the past few centuries. So they are mentioned here, you can see. The 18 species of plants are mentioned here. And among the animals, it is cheetah, the Sumatran rhinoceros, which are considered extinct in India, along with pink-headed duck, which is feared extinction, and the Himalayan quail, which was last reported in 1876. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.